Marlene, physical therapist here. I made this group last night and there's already almost 30 people, maybe even more by the time I post this, so I'm really excited that the group is growing. I said that I would post on how the format that I used on my telehealth sessions that I did, and then I have more coming up Friday. I am new to telehealth. I have been a part of some groups for a while, always wanting to do it, but kind of being, you know, like never doing it, but now we're all kind of forced to do it. And sometimes when you're in that situation, it makes you learn best. So I'm picking up on things. Right now, I do have my own little side hustle, whole motion therapy, but I work as a contractor with an early intervention group. I'm here in Virginia. So they use a coaching model versus formal physical therapy. So it's a lot of coaching the parent on kind of how to use different strategies and techniques and use it within their routine. So I felt like when I started doing telehealth, it really transitioned pretty well, because lots of times I am coaching the parents when I'm there in person, and now I'm just doing it through the telehealth platform. The sessions that I had on Monday, they weren't new patients, they were patients that I've seen before. So I always start off my session reviewing the previous session, because at the end of each session, we develop a joint plan on what they're going to practice from now until the next session. So we reflect on the previous session to see what activities they were able to incorporate into their routine to work on their child's goals. So we cover that, and I ask them if there's anything specifically that they want to focus on today. And then if they say yes or no, so they say yes, then I have them demonstrate how they're currently doing it. And then I'll give them tips. I may have a doll with me to demonstrate using a doll, or using myself, just depending on what it is. If they say there's not anything specific, we'll go back to our previous joint plan, what they've worked on. I'll ask them to show me how they're doing it. I'll give them techniques, and we'll kind of roll with the flow, depending on what the child wants to do also. Just like in person, if the kid needs a break because they're getting overwhelmed, you take a break. You're giving feedback throughout, and you kind of go through this, okay, demonstrate this for me. Okay, let me give you some strategies to maybe make it better. How did that feel? Did it feel different than how you were doing it before? And you can go through that process over and over again with each activity that was discussed in your previous joint plan or any new activities they want to do to help the child go through their goals. So we do that. Reflect on the strategies that we went over for the session. At the end of the session, we talk about the new joint plan, and if there was anything new that we did this session that they want to add to their joint plan that they feel they can use between now and the next session. And then depending on their frequency, I also may include reviewing the goals that we've met and haven't met, and to see if they have any other concerns. So my sessions were about 50, 55 minutes. Sometimes at the 45 mark, it was kind of like, oh, you know, so then I'd ask a lot of open-ended questions to keep the conversation going. So Monday was my first day, and I had three kids that I saw, and then Friday I'll have four. So I'd love for you all to share your format with little kids and older kids and how you're doing it. With the older kids, do you require the parent to still stay in the room? I would think that would be a good idea, but I'd love to hear your thoughts. And even if you have suggestions with adults, that would be awesome too. So thank you. I can't wait to hear what y'all have to share too. Bye.